Hereafter, we introduce you our research result. First to be mentioned is where these nine species have been observed during our field work. We have found Papilio de Morales on the east and west side of Western Ghat Mountains and everywhere except urban and high mountain areas. In contrast, Papilio lumedum has only been seen on the west side of the Western Ghat Mountains. It occurs from hillfoot habitats up to 800 meters in altitude. Papilio paris was recorded in forest areas on the east and west side of the Western Ghat Mountains. The areas where Papilio Buddha could be seen was on the west side of West Ghat Mountains. This is a similar distribution to that of Papilio lumedum. We also found one of the individuals of this species in Kerala. This is the only record among our 20 times of researches in this place. So we think this individual must move into here from somewhere. In contrast, Papilio crino, resembling Papilio Buddha in morphology, was only observed in the dry forest area on the east side of the Western Ghat Mountains and also around the Palakkad Gap. Papilio dravidarium was seen in forested areas on the east and west side of Western Ghat Mountains, like Papilio paris. Though the wing color pattern of Papilio dravidarium very closely resembles that of some Euphorbia species occurring in the same area, you can easily distinguish these butterflies when you carefully observe the antenna of these butterflies. That of Euphorbia species bend towards the underside. In contrast, that of the Papilio dravidarium bends to the dorsal side. Papilio helenus has also been found in the forest areas on the east and west side of Western Ghat Mountains, like Papilio paris and Papilio dravidarium. Papilio polites can be seen almost everywhere, including the urban area of Coimbatore City. The individual number of Papilio polites in each observation area are almost always more than that of Pacliopta species. These latter species are thought to be mimics of Papilio polites. The last species to mention is Papilio polymnestor. It was also found in many places. Its habitat seemed to include more forested areas compared to Papilio de Morales and Papilio polites. These findings have been summarized in this picture, where a green line shows the cross-section between Coimbatore and Calicut, and blue line shows that between Coimbatore and Coach. First, Papilio de Morales, Papilio helenus, Papilio polites, and Papilio polymnestor show an overall similar distribution pattern. They all occur on both sides of the Western Ghat Mountains widely, and sometimes their habitat expand into urban areas. Another distribution pattern is that shared by Papilio paris and Papilio dravidarium. This pattern resembles to the previous one, but is limited to forest area. A third pattern is the one shared by Papilio lumedum and Papilio buddha. Their habitat appears limited to the western side of the Western Ghat Mountains. And the last pattern is the one exhibited by Papilio crino. This species is limited to dry forests and the savanna area on the east side of Western Ghat Mountains. These distribution patterns closely related to the ecology of each species, and so this now leads to the discussion of observations on the ecology of the different species. Now we show the behavior of Papilio butterflies. One of the most important attributes of the different species is their feeding behavior, and this has been captured by movie. Now we summarize these movies. First, we show you the plant species visited by Papilio butterflies. Papilio demoralis and Papilio polites, which have a widespread habitat, come into contact with many kinds of flowers and nectar. In contrast, the other seven species mainly come into contact with flowers of the Verbenaceae, Laminaceae, Rubiaceae, and Malvaceae. Next, we show you the preference of flower color for Papilio butterflies. This picture shows the flower color preference of six Japanese Papilio species in the greenhouse of the Adachi Park of Living Things, observed in July 1997. All these species butterfly prefer red and pink flowers. In contrast, Vicetini Chandra shows that Fijian Papilio schmelzii prefers blue color flowers. We have arranged data in the previous table according to flower color preferences. From this table, only Papilio demoreus, Papilio crino, and Papilio polites visited blue and yellow flowers. Papilio butterflies preferred red Helicteris isola, Ixora duffy, and pale pink Clerodendron viscosum. Additionally, visitation was made to multicolor lantana camera. All Papilio species displayed nectaring behavior on these four plant flowers. Finally, we rearranged the table one more time, according flower size and height from the ground. Short and small flowers were visited by Papilio demoreus, Papilio crino, and Papilio polites. Slightly higher flowers, Ixora duffy and lantana camera, were visited by many species. However, Papilio demoreus, Papilio crino, and Papilio polites do not so prefer Ixora duffy. We hypothesize that this is due to the length of Ixora duffy flower variants and the relatively smaller size of these three Papilio species. On this point, lantana is the preferable flower for all Papilio species. The flower of Euphorbia pargerrima, a tall plant, was well visited by Papilio polites. The size of flower appears good for this species. Clerodendron viscosum was visited by many species. And presumably, the shape and size of this flower is good for Papilio butterflies.